नमस्ते, मेलिंडा एंड बिल गेट्स, यूनियन मिनिस्टर इन माय कैबिनेट डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन, डेलीगेट्स फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड, साइंटिस्ट, इनोवेटर्स, रिसर्चर्स, स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रेंड्स, आई एम हैप्पी टू बी विथ ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द 16th ग्रांड चैलेंजेस एनुअल मीटिंग. This meeting was to be held physically in India, but in changed circumstances, it is being held virtually. Such is the power of technology that a global pandemic did not keep us apart. This program has continued as per schedule. This shows the commitment of the Grand Challenges community. It shows a commitment to adapt and innovate. Friends, the future will be shaped by societies that invest in science and innovation. But this cannot be done in a short-sighted manner. One has to invest in science and innovation well in advance. That is when we can reap benefit at the right time. Similarly, the journey to these innovations must be shaped by collaboration and public participation. Science will never prosper in silos. The Grand Challenges program has understood this ethos well. The scale of this program is commendable. In 15 years, you have engaged with several nations. The nature of issue address is diverse. You have combined bright global talent to address problems such as antimicrobial resistance, maternal and child health, agriculture, nutrition, wash, water, sanitation and hygiene. Friends, it has taken a global pandemic to make us realize yet again the importance of teamwork. After all, diseases do not have geographic boundaries. Diseases do not discriminate on the grounds of faith, race, gender, or color. And by disease, I am not only talking about the current pandemic situation. There are several communicable and non. They have been India's greatest assets, especially during the last several months while fighting COVID-19. From containment to capacity building, they have achieved wonders. Friends, India's size, scale, and diversity has always made the global community curious. Our population is almost 4 times that of USA. Many of our states are as populated as other nations in Europe and Asia. Yet, thanks to a people-powered and people-driven approach, India kept its COVID-19 death rate very low. Today, we are seeing a decline in the number of cases per day and in the growth rate ऑफ केसेस. इंडिया हैज वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट रिकवरी रेट ऑफ 88%. दिस हैपन बिकॉज इंडिया वॉज वन ऑफ द फर्स्ट कंट्रीज टू एडॉप्ट ए फ्लेक्सिबल लॉकडाउन व्हेन द टोटल केसेस वेर जस्ट अ फ्यू हंड्रेड. India was one of the first to encourage the usage of masks. India actively began to work on effective contact tracing. India was one of the earliest to deploy the rapid antigen tests. Friends, India is now at the forefront of vaccine development for COVID. Some of them are in advanced stages. We are not stopping here. India is already working on putting a well-established vaccine delivery system in place. This digitized network, along with digital health ID, will be used to ensure immunization of our citizens. Friends, beyond COVID too, India is known for its proven capacity to produce quality medicines and vaccine at low cost. More than 60% of the vaccines of global immunization are being manufactured in India. We included indigenous rotavirus vaccine in our Indradhanush immunization program. This is a successful example of a strong partnership for a long-lasting results. The Gates Foundation has also been a part of this particular effort. With India's experience and research talent, we will be at the center of global healthcare efforts. We want to help other nations enhance their capacities in these sectors. Friends, in the last 6 years, we have made many interventions which are contributing to a better healthcare system. Take a subject such as sanitation, improved cleanliness, more toilet coverage. Who does this help the most? It helps the poor and underprivileged. It leads to a fall in disease. It also helps women the most. Friends, now we are ensuring that each household gets piped drinking water. This will further ensure disease reduction. We are setting up more medical colleges, especially in rural areas. This ensures more opportunities for the youth. It brings better healthcare to our villages. We are running the world's largest health insurance scheme and ensuring access to everyone. Friends, may we keep using our collaborative spirit for individual empowerment and collective well-being. The Gates Foundation and several other organizations are doing wonderful work. I wish you all fruitful and productive discussions over the next 3 days. I hope to see many exciting and encouraging new solutions coming out from this grand challenging platform. May these efforts further a human-centric approach to development. May they also give our youth the opportunities to be thought leaders for a brighter future. Once again, I thank the organizers for inviting me. Thank you. Thank you very much.